This is Paul McKenna for PT Boxing. I'm here today at the Hilton in Liverpool with me, Teddy Matthews. First of all, how are you, mate? Okay?
All right, mate, all good.
Good stuff. Here today, your next fight, February the 13th, taking on Terry Flanagan for the WBO lightweight title. Shaping up to be a good fight and looking forward to the new year now.
Yeah, I'm looking forward, you know. I've obviously been in camp for a while. I've been training, getting my weight down, doing the best condition I can do and getting right for the fight, so... February the 13th, I'll have no excuses and I'll be winning the world title.
Obviously, you've been in the ring with Terry before a few years ago in Prize Fighter, but since then he's improved as of yourself. So, you know, you feel like you're peaking now in your career and time to show that in your, what will be your 50th professional fight on the 13th?
Yeah, I've had a long, hard career, but you know, it's one I've enjoyed. And February the 13th, it doesn't come much bigger than this, fighting for a world title. My own city, in front of my own crowd. Everything what Frank said he was going to deliver, he's delivered. Yeah. Management team have got me this fight and I'm over the moon. Daniel said to me that we'll fight for a world title in a new year and I am. So, you know, couldn't be in a better position.
That's it. Obviously, Frank's just mentioned up there that, you know, the winner of this fight, he's made a $500,000 offer to Andy Crawler. If you come through successful on February the 13th, a fight that you'll be willing to take a third fight with Crawler for a nice amount.
Let's just focus on this fight first. That fight's always going to be there. No matter what, Andy Crawler can't beat me, but Frank's offered him $500,000, so I win the world title. What are they going to pay me? His team, they're going to have to pay me a lot more money, so... No, so that's a little bit more driving in camp. It's a lot of money to secure my family's future, and you know, so
that's it.
No Christmas for me this year. She'll have me training Christmas Day.
I know you were supposed to be originally fighting on December 19th, but that's not happening now.
No, it's not happening. My manager and my trainer and myself sat down and we just said, "No, what? Not we're taking a risk. Might get a cut, a bad hand, a sore leg. Anything can happen in camp. Yeah. Anything can happen." So. Why risk it? And not just that, back-to-back camps as well. I can ease off the training now and then. We can build a long camp and we can condition and coach staff. I can set the programme. So,
yeah.
You know, I'm in a good position. I'm ready to spend Christmas knuckle down early nights, training, running in the snow back home and then I head out to sunny Spain.
Yeah, as far as it goes out there in Marbella, everyone I speak to about it always has these rave reviews and every few months another big name seems to be added to the camp, so it must be buzzing out there.
Yeah, we're MGM, the top of boxing, and it's only going to keep growing and growing and growing. Some young fighters, up-and-coming fighters, then you've got Billy Joe Saunders, who's the top of the tee, Michelle fighting for the world title, Liam Smith, who is a world champion, so you've got like Joe Selk, Jamie Conlon, from Ireland, who's flying at the moment. He's going to have a big fight with Paul Butler maybe in the future.
Stalker as well.
Stalker, who Olympic captain. You know, look who they've signed over the last couple of years, and it's only going to keep growing and growing and growing, and long may it continue. And I'm a lucky man that I'm a part of a good team. I've got a great manager, Daniel. I've got great people in the gym, Anto, and then I've got Danny, in my eyes, the best coach in the world.
Yeah.
I've got Taffy, does my conditioning. No, I couldn't be in a better position in my career. I wish I would have had this setup. If I'd have had this setup, 10 years ago, when I turned pro 13 years ago. But if I'd have had this about 10 years ago, you know, I could have been retired now, being a world champion and gone on to bigger things.
Do you think, as far as the fight goes, like obviously you've got a world class team behind you and trainer and so on, but you know, as you said up there, do you think it's really your fight to lose?
Yeah, it is, and I've got everything, you know, it's in my city, I asked for the fight. I could have went the WBA route, but I decided that I wanted to win the WBO world title, and I'm fighting for a full world title, and I'm over the moon.
All right, mate, well, thanks a lot for your time, Daddy, and we'll catch up with you soon.
All right, cheers, thank you.